It is Saturday. Some come before sunrise, others later, depending on their chores at home. Over 400 women with their embroidery work of 15 days. The wait can be long, so they carry on embroidering and chatting. They are patient. Sister Lucia sits at the window from 6 in the morning, scissors in hand. Women show her their work. Her roving eyes never miss a mistake. Tiny scissors are like an extension of her fingers. They cut up the faulty work, it has to be redone. The women never complain. They too value the quality of their work. The beautiful pieces of art embroidered by poor women are exported. Slackness in quality control would threaten the very existence of our cooperative. Her no-compromise attitude has another reason behind it. She knows the potential of her women and respects the pride they take in their work. So, zero mistakes. Each piece has to be just right, no more, no less. The good quality work is sent for further processing.
They are feeling very proud of the good embroidery. And many people, when they don't do properly, other the neighbors why say, why you don't do well? Because this is about pride, no? We're having one leader, they go from house to ask them, you do properly, because you have to be proud.
St. Mary's Mahila Shikshan Kendra, Ahmedabad, India, is a cooperative of some 450 women. Before another hectic day begins, Sister Lucia and Sister Sylvia meet to go over the tasks of the day. Invoking God at the beginning of work is an act of faith and hope. A wider meeting of key workers is an exercise in participation and creativity. Till some years ago, Sister Lucia and Vijay, our artist, struggled to create a range of new designs every year after studying the fashion trends in the West. Many samples were sent to the clients. They chose a few with modifications. It was a slow, expensive, and time-consuming process. With computers and internet, the clients now sent us detailed designs. The production process is long, and almost all of it is done by our women manually. A needle, thread, mirrors, and handloom cloth make our beautiful embroidery pieces. Yes, the cloth comes from faraway Chennai and is dyed in Ahmedabad in a rainbow of colors. The thread comes from Delhi, and the family of Rasida, one of our veteran members, dyes it into a whole spectrum of colors. The mirrors come from Limdi. The cloth is cut in various sizes and stretched. The designs are stamped on the cloth. Mirrors are counted and packed. Threads of the required colors are chosen. Bundles by the hundreds every week are made with the cloth stamped with design, mirrors and thread of various colors. Women embroider in their little one-room homes for hours. In between, they get up to feed the baby, to clean the house, to wash clothes, to cook, and to do 100 other household chores of a poor housewife. In the midst of 1,000 preoccupations, they create works of art that has to pass the minutest scrutiny of Sister Lucia. The sisters are with them, woman to woman, concerned for their welfare and joy, and that of their families. The women bring their embroidered pieces on Wednesdays and Saturdays and take new work home. Once the embroidery work has cleared the rigorous quality check, there is a whole process of getting it ready for export. The articles are washed thoroughly, dried, and ironed. Thank you. tailors transform the pieces of embroidered cloth into hundreds of articles, bed sheets and bags, tablecloth and toilet bags, wall hangings and window curtains, passport bags and children's pencil pouches. The fashions abroad and the creativity of St. Mary's team result in new designs and items. The finished products are again checked for defects and then packed for export. Finally, they are ready to head for Europe, the USA, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, etc. by air or sea, depending on the urgency of the client. International NGOs, convinced of and committed to just and fair international trade, flock to St. Mary's Mahila Shikshan Kendra with orders for our women's exquisite works of art. Till recently, we had plenty of orders, sometimes creating problems with dispatch deadlines. The worldwide economic depression has now reduced our orders. Our international NGO partners appreciate our women and their work